When you're driving down the road, take notice of the color-shaped signs that you pass. Some may be a diamond, others may be a rectangle, maybe even a triangle. These signs are colorful, but the colors and shapes of these metal signs that for many drivers are just a part of traveling are actually more like a code for the driver. There is a history behind the markings of the road. This is the history behind the shapes and colors of our signs.
Well, if you ever plan to motor west, Jack, take my way, it's the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66.
Well, the history begins all the way back during the early years of the automobile travel, the early 1900s. Good times. Back then, roads were more like a game that was similar to crossing roads than an actual road, as these early travel ways were shared by horses, trolleys, cars, and people. With the introduction of the automobile and its popularity growing, the ways the road functioned and the rules that had to be followed needed to change, because it was more like a matter of changing the rules to save lives. The change comes from Detroit, Michigan. Yes, this is where the history of road signs begin. Oftentimes, these traffic signs are used as examples in math classes, mostly geometry, but it's not the reason behind the shapes they come in. With the increase of automobile travel in the early 1900s, once again, great time, the increase for accidents also happened. Due to the lack of laws or rules, people just kind of went along like they always did, but in Detroit, after a few deaths caused by traffic accidents, it was clear to them that the lawless or loose rules of the road needed to change. They needed to become more strict to prevent people from, dying? People back then would walk on the road and cross it without waiting for a clear opening, similar to the fast-paced lifestyle of the early 1900s. People didn't have time nor patience to wait for an opening to happen. But let's be honest, people today, still very impatient. It was a Detroit police sergeant that was the creator of the first stop sign in 1915. Back then, it wasn't a red stop sign that we know today, but rather yellow with black lettering, because the red faded too quickly. And also because there wasn't the technology enough to allow illuminated signs that help us see them in the dark. The sign was also smaller than the current sign, measuring only a 24 by 24 inches. So, there it was. The first sign of the road. Most signs back then were yellow and black, despite they wanted to colorize them. It was a good idea, but once again, technology was years away, so instead, they turned to shape. This way, the signs meeting will be able to be identified. So here's where we make our first stop in the history of traffic signs. Now, a group of people got together and discussed the look of the signs to indicate what they mean, without having the definition having to be printed on them. It came up with a very complicated system. That system says the number of sides the sign has is equal to the level of danger the sign means. Okay, fine, it's not that complicated. More sides, higher level of danger. It's quite simple. But it's funny to say it's complicated. The circle has an infinite number of sides in this system, so it is used for the most dangerous obstacles, railroads. Railroad also has the X sign too, the crossbuck, but back in the day, these X signs could also be arranged in a diamond shape that said, watch for the car. Watch the tram car, please.
Watch the tram car, please. Watch the tram car, please.
Watch. The octagon is the stop sign. It's probably the most recognized sign in traffic sign fleet, as it's one of the most used signs in the country. It is also the most ignored sign in the country, and also one of the most destroyed and vandalized signs because they constantly getting knocked down in traffic accidents. But let's be honest, if you were paying attention to the sign that said stop, it probably wouldn't have happened. Let's think about that. The upside down triangle is used by yield signs, which means slow down, another sign that seems to be ignored quite often. The sideways triangle, also known as the pennant, is used and can often be seen with the words no passing on them. The diamonds are warning signs that tell a driver of any upcoming changes in the road, merging, added lanes. They also can be used for construction. A lot of your construction signs do use the diamond. Rectangles are for regulatory, like speed limits, and pentagons are for school crossings. These shapes do what signs can't. Tell the driver what is going to happen without words. A driver can't read a message that says what's going to happen when driving at 55 plus miles per hour. So these shapes do it for the signs, and it's up to the driver to understand their meaning and follow them accordingly. However, not many people truly understand the meaning behind the signs. Our brains just kind of know. With how many of these signs you see in the road, it's kind of hard to imagine a time where the signs were missing from them. Color was just an idea when it came to the first road signs, but as I said, due to technology not being techy enough, signs had to be yellow and black. Similar to the warning signs we see today, except every sign was yellow and black. Remember that due to colors not being able to illuminate in the dark yet, yellow was just bright enough on its own to do that. The colors also faded faster, which would lead to a constant touch-up, and let's be honest, who the hell wants to touch up a sign like every 6 months? Not me! Actually, that'd probably be kind of satisfying, but still, that's a lot of work. It wasn't until around the 1950s when a porcelain enamel came into the picture that would allow the signs to get their color we know today. The colors have also have a meaning. Like the shapes. The meaning goes together, creating a sign that it's easy for drivers to understand. The colors that don the sign include red, which is used for stop and yield. Red is kind of like the universal color for stop. Green is directions, you see these on the freeway. Blue, service for travelers. Rest area signs, ones for food, lodging, gas. Yellow, general warning, one of the most common sign colors. Fluorescent yellow. And green. School crosswalks. White is information, which can be speed limits. Orange, roadwork, oftentimes these signs can be metal or fabric, roll-up signs, as they call them. And brown, which is recreation, such as zoos, theme parks, natural parks. I've also seen another color being pink. I've seen construction signs before, the roll-up ones. And brown actually wasn't an original color, but was added later on. Sometimes signs are made with different designs. The ones that are normal are like your traditional stop, yield, railroad. Those are your normal ones. But I've seen ones that are like duck crossing instead of deer crossing. At where I live, there's ducks, so we put duck crossing. There's also one saying welcome when you enter the borders across states. Welcome to Ohio. Discovery. Oh, they changed the sign. What the hell? Plant entrances. I saw church entrances. And those signs differ in countries. Most actually do have the same or similar meanings. The shape and color just differ. However, this raccoon crossing sign is very different. If you're wondering, Japanese. With the shape and color, road signs haven't changed much. Of course, new designs and colors have been introduced, but the system in which they work hasn't. These signs help drivers get around, follow rules, and save their lives. These signs coincide with the introduction of the traffic light and road markings, which also help keep the roads safe and ordered. Even though every state has its different traffic laws, the something that is always the same is the iconic, well-known, colorful shaped signs that guide us to our next destination.
Cause it knows I need you so.